We all love coding, and there are many programming languages too. From working on many development projects to writing automations in various languages, we often use different code editors or a more focused tool like IDE. And this video is all about the most amazing tools a developer uses and spends most of their time working. So first let's see what is the difference between an IDE and a code editor. An IDE, short for Integrated Development Environment, is one of the most powerful programming tools that combine the different aspects of a computer program into a single GUI. A code editor is one of the most important tools for programmers, specifically designed to edit the source code of a computer programs. A code editor is basically a text editor, but it is also designed to help you write code. If you see functionality-wise, an IDE is a text editor, a code editor, a debugger, compiler, and more, all under a single tool belt. It consolidates many of the functions like code creation, building, and testing together in a single framework, service, or application, allowing you to work on different modules of the same project in an organized manner. A code editor can either be a standalone software program or a part of an IDE or a web browser. It helps you color your code and provides you with more advanced tools like making code easier for you. This video will be all about code editors. These are my favorite open source tools which I'm currently using on my day-to-day job or have used it before. This will be my personal opinion, but let me know which one do you find best and use regularly in the comment section below. On 5th place, I have placed Sublime Text Editor. The Sublime Text Editor is for Windows, Linux, and Mac OS, and it supports around 46 languages. Following is the list of few supported languages by Sublime Text. Its main features include like it can detect and highlight syntax errors. For the whole project, it can automatically create an index for class, method, and functions, provide smart options for opening files, jumping to symbols, etc. It allows you to edit multiple lines simultaneously. And with the help of JSON file, you can almost customize everything in this code editor. The latest addition is the GPU rendering. Sublime Text now utilizes your GPU on Linux, Mac, and Windows when rendering the interface. There are few cons too, like there are no package manager with this editor, the printing function is not available, and some basic functions like compare file do not exist by default, and it requires the installation of third-party plugins. But it comes with few pros. It has lint for several languages by default. If you close the program, the next time when you run it, files that were open in the previous session will be displayed again, even those that have not been saved. The tool is not completely free and you have to buy the license for $99, but a free trial version is also available. I will provide the link of all these tools in the description box below, so make sure to check it out. At 4th place we have Notepad++. Notepad++ is a source code editor for Windows, Linux, and Unix machines. It can also be used on Mac OS, but we have to use a third-party tool to install that. Its latest available version is 8.1.4, which has features like it supports macros, recording, and playbacks. For ease of use, it provides many features like adding bookmarks, finding and replacing tasks, auto-completion, and syntax highlighting. It supports multi-view and tab interfaces for multi-documents. There are few cons with Notepad++, like remote file editing is not available for HTTP and SSH connections. And if you want to use Notepad++ on Mac OS, then you have to use a third-party tool to install it. But there are few pros, like spelling check option is provided, easy to use for beginners as well, and there is a good community support from GitHub. The license for Notepad++ is completely free. It is a free code editor. It is used for coding in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and PHP. Its code highlighting functionality helps in writing the code without error. On 3rd place, we have Brackets. Brackets is a text editor for web designing or web development. It is an open source tool. It can be used on Windows, Linux, and Mac OS. Its most important features are like it is extensible, it is very lightweight and powerful tool. Bracket provides the feature of live preview. With the help of this feature, you will be able to see the changes made to your CSS or HTML file in your browser instantly. And it also provides inline editors. There are few cons like autocomplete options is missing, third-party plugins are not supported, and full screen and split screen options are not supported. But on the other hand, it provides new features and bug fixes through regular updates. It is easy to customize brackets and you can preview the code which is going to establish the connection. The license for Bracket is absolutely free. Bracket also have a very good community support. Next, the runner-up of our list is Atom. Atom is a text and source code editor which is developed by GitHub. It is an open source tool and user can use it very easily. Its features are like it includes a built-in package manager. It provides smart options for auto-completion. You can open the tools in multiple panes for comparison. It also supports cross-platform editing. It provides more features for finding and replacing text and for searching files. The only con with this text editor is for writing packages, you will need to know CoffeeScript, which many won't be familiar with. But on the other side, pros are like it is very easy to use and set up. It provides some special developer tools like built-in package managers, and it is very easy to customize the UI as it is built over HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And it provides many themes. The license for this code editor is also free, and it has a very good community support. You can use Atom for basic and advanced programming. Next, the leader of this list is Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is a lightweight but powerful source code editor which runs on your desktop and is available for Windows, macOS, and Linux. It comes with built-in support for JavaScript, TypeScript, and Node.js, and has a rich ecosystem of extensions for other languages and runtimes. Visual Studio Code can be used for almost all the available languages that are currently running in the market. Its features include syntax highlighting, auto-completion for variable types, function definitions, and important modules. Debugging with breakpoints, call stacks, and an interactive console also give it a good boost. Visual Studio Code is extensible and customizable. The only con with this software which I have faced is like it is sometimes the system runs very slow on Linux machines. Otherwise, the system is lightweight tool and it doesn't take much space or RAM. The license for Visual Studio Code is currently free. Visual Studio Code is my first preference in the list of tools that I am currently using. It has a lot of community support, and not only this, it supports many extensions and direct integration with GitHub. It has many themes and you can customize the editor according to your taste. And the best and the latest thing which I like about Visual Studio Code is GitHub Copilot. The GitHub Copilot extension is only present for Visual Studio Code. If you don't know what is GitHub Copilot, it is your AI peer programmer. It predicts the whole code snippet and helps you in writing a function based on your comment. For more information on GitHub Copilot, you can watch my video. In that video, I have demonstrated the complete use of GitHub Copilot. If you are using any other editor apart from these, let me know in the comment section and I will definitely give it a try. This list is my personal preference. I have used each of these tools for at least a month in the past. Let me know if you need any video on any specific topic. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. You can DM me on Instagram if you want to be part of my next video. Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel. I will see you in the next video next week. Till then, stay safe and keep learning.